best scouting in New England starts when it's warm enough to put your flannel pajamas away for the winter. When temperatures get up to be about 40 or 50 degrees, Paersilla emerges from hibernation and starts to mate and lay eggs. These overwintering forms of Paersilla are a little bit different than the others that you see throughout the year. This winter form is a dark black color. It's almost like a big gnat, but when you take a closer look at it, you can see that it's actually a cicada-like insect, and it's got these tented wings, and the body looks just like a cicada, except much, much smaller. In order to monitor for the adults, one of the things that you can do is get a beading tray, or if you don't have one of those on hand, you can use a white sheet. We happen to have a blanket in the car, so we're going to use that today. And so what you're going to do when you're monitoring for these winter adults is you're going to get this set out and you're going to tap on these branches on your pear tree. And then you're going to count the adults. You're going to do 10 samples like this in an acre. More than an acre, you're going to do 20 samples. And basically your average of 0.2 adults is your action threshold. This time of year, a little bit earlier, as you can see, the buds have sort of come out on the trees here. Before this point, you would want to get on a dormant boil, and that's going to prevent them from egg laying. Now, I said that the threshold is an average of 0.2 adults per sample, but really, if you had damage last year, you're going to know this. Your branches are going to be covered in sooty mold. It will have been all over the fruit, and this is from the excretions that the nymphs make when they feed. If you had that damage, you should just be doing a dormant oil spray for Paersilla anyway. When you do make that dormant application, of course, you need to be careful to avoid those freezing temperatures because the oil with the freezing temperatures will damage the fruit buds.